this morning with Darryn McClelland from Asiamet. Darryn, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. Nice to be with you again.
Good to speak again, Darryn. Look, good couple of weeks since you and I last caught up. How are you settling into your new role at Asiamet?
Yeah, it's going well. Very, very busy. Certainly been able to get definitely into the detail and the weeds of our BKM copper feasibility study update. Spending a lot of time with the team here in both here in Jakarta and also getting to spend some more time in Central Kalimantan with our team. So that's been really good getting to understand and know the capabilities of our group. So yeah, it's a good small but committed team wanting to certainly see this process through. So So that's been good. A lot of work with the various consultants that are we're working with on the feasibility study. Spending a lot more time and you know, understanding, you know, a lot of the detail around the work we're doing. So no, it's been good. It doesn't feel like a new job anymore. So certainly feels like fully into it now. So really enjoying it, and it's been encouraging to be able to share some news certainly in this last month. Related to the company and the project. So that's been good. Being able to devote some more time to some of our corporate activities and some of the shareholder requirements as well. So it's been really good, really interesting and diverse first 6 months, Andrew.
Well, look, indeed, you've had three key news items out so far this month. Just back at the start of the month, announcing Delta Junior increasing their strategic stake in Asiamet. Tell us a bit more here.
Yeah, sure. So we had been discussing with Delta Junior or Doid for a period of time. Looking at continuing to support the business. They remain, as our largest shareholder, remain very supportive of the work we're doing. They themselves, you know, have their own sort of strategy in how they want to approach diversification of their business, and has been stated by them publicly that moving into the metal space is definitely an area that they are keen to pursue, and certainly this investment in Asiamet is a key part of that, and being able to diversify some of their interests away from, well, not in line with coal, but also with some of the future facing metals that Asiamet is abundant with. So yeah, so we had discussed a number of options ourselves and with myself and the board, and you know, felt that going through a private placement at a reasonable premium was you know, we thought was our best opportunity at this particular point in time. Those funds certainly give us a significant runway into next year, so sort of allows us to be able to make sure continue everything we do with the feasibility study update, make sure that we can definitely get through the processes for financing, and also probably importantly there's some runway there for some obligations which are required that come up as a requirement of completing our major permitting. So really important that we understand that, you know, there are financial obligations that come with, you know, moving through our permitting stage. So it was important to make sure that we had enough runway for those processes. So yeah, it felt at a reasonable premium to the market price. Unfortunately, the market price isn't exactly where we would have liked it to be, but good to see that that's stabilizing now and starting to trend back up slowly. So it's encouraging.
And these other two announcements, Darryn, relate to the work you're doing on the feasibility study.
Sure. Yeah, I'll talk through those now, Andrew. The first one was related to operating costs. So that was been doing a lot of work. It's the feasibility study in general. You know, we are going back to first principles in a number of, areas. So it's probably not as simple an exercise as probably first envisaged. But yeah, it's been going back to first principles and really assessing, you know, all of the key inputs into the feasibility study and what we reported on to two major aspects for any metals extraction process. Yeah, one of the key consumables, which a lot of metals processing operations are understanding now, sulfuric acid. So that's a really big cost component of any metals extraction plant. So we've been reviewing how we estimate and how we, the estimation and assumption of how much we'll consume of that process, and been able to look at and understand that we'll have probably much lower consumption than what we originally thought. And something simple, BKM is going to be operating in a very wet climate. We know that. One of the key items from the independent technical review was reviewing the climate analysis and that study. And you know, it's very topical, of course, at the moment. And really going back and understanding, you know, having a look at, we had more data. One of the key things is that we had a lot more information available to us 5 years down the track from when we studied this in 2017. So we're able to include all of that in our analysis and led to some positive outcomes in the fact that, you know, the average rainfall across the site will be less, and that has a huge impact on aspects of managing the operation. So there's some positives that came out of that. The second key announcement was a set of life of mine physicals. So we've been working through this for a significant number of months, and it was really important that there's a lot of there's a lot of interaction and interconnectivity between mining and processing in a heap leach operation, and we've been gone back to first principles of our mining pit optimization, and then also looking at the mining scheduling and also the processing scheduling associated with the heap leach. And there's been a lot of interactive work and iterative work, I guess is a good word, because it's you have to develop outcomes, see the results of those, and then sometimes go back to the start and sort of redo some of those things. So it's been a really interesting exercise, and that has delivered the outcomes which we released about a week ago. Initially, some people might have the response that I have seen coming back from that has been positive, which is good. I guess we've been wanting to reflect a lot on quality and not so much on quantity. So one of the key takeaways from that was, whilst our overall metal production is down a bit from our previous feasibility study, down by about 10%, we only have to process and mine about 2/3 of the material that we had in our previous feasibility study. So that is going a long way to containment of costs, and with long-term metal pricing where it's sitting now, and you know, the information we have, still looks like the revenue from the project will be at or in excess of what the 2019 feasibility study demonstrated. So in all, this is a strategy of focusing on quality, sort of reshaping and re-optimizing the project, and you know, a lot to do with containment of costs, because that is obviously the some aspects of the macro environment are leading into those in cost inflation pressures. So yeah, it's been a huge amount of work, and probably one of the key reasons that we've been a bit slower in releasing information is having to redo some of this work. So that's that has released a lot of downstream work by being able to close all of this out.
Is it a bit soon to be talking about the debt financing process?
Probably a little bit, Andrew. We are the key plank to the debt financing process is completion of the feasibility study. So we're working hard on all of our work streams. There's a lot of things happening in parallel, not too many things happening in series here. There's a whole range of things which are all happening together. We've been able to release a number of work streams with completing some of the technical work sort of earlier this month and later in October. So a lot of those are pushing ahead. As we had explained previously, the fact that we have had an independent technical expert review our previous feasibility study, give us input into that. It's a group that would likely be engaged in the debt financing process as a technical reviewer for the project. So yeah, our study is working on addressing or the things that were raised by the independent reviewer. So that is part of the process which we think is going to keep us in good stead when we come to those discussions.
Good to see you this morning. Darryn, thanks very much.
Excellent. Thanks, Andrew. Hope to talk again soon. Thank you.